Hi everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, let us try to learn how to handle XML file in Java. So especially whenever you want to deal with XML files and we don't need to get any third-party libraries. So Java itself is having their own library called Java DOM parser. And by using that Java DOM parser, we can parse our XML file and we can read the data from the XML file. So before doing that, we need to understand something from XML file and the structure of XML file and how we can specify data in XML file and so on. So let me explain by taking some example here. I have a small XML file, employees.xml. And if I look at this XML file, which contains some employees data, and we need to understand some basic terminology from this. And if I look at this XML file, this employees is basically root tag, we can also call it as a root node. And inside this, we have a different nodes. So this is data of one employee, this is another employee data, and this is another employee data. So these are all called child nodes of the root node. This employee is starting node here, and this is a closing node. And this is a child, one child node, and this is another child node, and this is another child node. So we can have n number of child nodes in one root node. Now, if I look at any node here, this is a child node. Inside the child node, we have a different tags. This is one tag, and this is another tag, and this is another tag. So this actual tag contains the data, which is called text content. So every tag is having some data. Right. So this is a basic terminology which we have to understand. What is a root node and what is a child node? And what is a child node contains different tags and tags contains the text content. Now our ultimate goal is we want to read the text content from every tag, also from every node. So when you're parsing this XML file, first we need to get this entire XML file as a document. And from that document, we have to capture the root node. From that root node, we have to capture all the child nodes. Depends on the number of child nodes, we have to repeat the loop in which, again, we have to read each and every tag from the child node. And again, from the tag, we have to extract the data or text content. So this is the process of parsing XML file using DOM parser. So DOM parser is a built-in library which is available in Java itself. So for that, we no need to add any third-party library. Now let us see how can we parse this XML file using Java. Now let me create a new package. This is my new Java project which is created, Maven Java project. And XML files is a new package which I have created. Inside this, I'm creating new class. I'll name it as read XML file. Take this main method and say finish. Okay, so here we are going to use a built-in library from Java, which is Java DOM parser. Java DOM parser. So DOM is nothing but document object model. Okay, so Java DOM parser. So by using this, we will able to parse our XML file. We'll read the data from XML file. This is what a built-in Java library. Okay. Now, so the first step, it is going to be different steps. The first step, we have to get XML file as a document. So here, employees.xml file I have. Now I want to get this entire XML file as a document. And that, first we need to parse it and we need to get the document. So we have a special classes provided in Java DOM parser. And one is document builder library. Another one is document builder and then document. So these are the three main classes which we are going to use when you parsing XML file. So the first one is document. Okay, document builder factory. This is one class. And the second thing is document builder. And the third class is document. So these are the three important things which we are going to use to parse the XML file as a document. So first we need to create an object for document builder factory. So we are not going to create an object. In this particular class, we have a static method called new instance. Okay, new instance. So this particular method will return, this new instance will return the document builder factory. So that we are going to store in a variable. I'm creating a variable called factory. And the type of this variable is what? Document builder factory. So that we have to specify. This is the first step. Once you get a document builder factory, from this, we have to get a document builder. So this document builder, we have to capture. So how to capture? By using this factory, the next step. So factory dot new document builder. So new document builder. So this particular method will return a builder type of object. So this will throw some exception. Just add this. Now this new document builder, this particular method will return document builder type of object. So that we are going to store in another variable. I call it as a builder. Now the type of this variable is what? Document builder. Document builder. So this is the second step. This is a document builder. So that we need to import from javax.xml.parsers. Okay. So now we have got, document builder factory. From that, we are extracted a new document builder. And now by using this builder, we can parse our XML file. So for this, what you need to do, take this builder object, builder dot, there is a method called parse. And here we can parse XML file directly. You can specify the location of XML file, or you can create a file object where you can specify XML file, and that you can pass it here. So I'm directly passing my XML file that is available in my directory, in my current project location, ./, the data folder. My XML file name is employees.xml. I say employees.xml. All right, so this is the parse, and this will throw some exception. Just add this. Now this particular method will return actual XML document. After parsing, it will return the document object that we are going to store. Another variable, I'm creating one variable called document, and the type of this document is what? Document type. So this is how we can use these three special classes, and this document also we have to import from. This document is having a special class that we need to import from org.w3c.com. So all these things we have to import from this. You can see org.w3c.dom. All right, so now we have done. First we have created document builder factory. From that we have extracted new document builder. By using this builder, we are able to parse XML file into a document. So now finally we are able to get the XML document. So once you get an XML document, the next step is we have to extract the elements, right? Root element. So this is the employees is the root element, which contains multiple things. Okay, so the root node we have to extract. From there, we will navigate to the child nodes. And again, from there, we will navigate to the each and every tag, and then we will extract the text content. So that is a step-by-step process. Now we need to extract the root node from this particular XML document. So how to extract the root node from the document? So step number, extract root node from XML doc. To extract it, we need to use this document object. And in this, we have a method called getDocumentElement. Okay, getDocumentElement. So this will actually returns the root node of the XML document, which we call it as an element. So this will return an element type of object that is a root node actually. So I can call it as a root. And the type of this variable is what? Element. The root element, we can simply say. And this element also we have to import from java.w3c.dom. Okay, the same package, the same class is available in different packages. You need to carefully import the right package. So org.w3c.dom. So this is the package we have to import. So we got the root element from the XML file. If we go back to XML file, we capture the root element. And by using this root element, we have to capture all the child elements or child nodes. So how can we extract it? We have to use one more method by taking help of this root. We use one method called getChildNodes. So this will return all child nodes or child elements, list of child elements. And the return type of this method is node list. Okay, node list. So let me create a variable here, node list. And the type of variable is also node list type. That is a return type. So this node list also we need to import from w3c.dom. This is org.w3c.dom. Okay. So what we have done here is we have extracted the root node from XML file. From the root node or from the root element, we extracted all the child nodes into this child nodes or child elements. Now we need to read each and every child node. And from every child node, again, we have to extract all the tags and their content. So how many child nodes are there in XML file in the root node? Those many times we have to repeat a loop statement. So here I'm going to create a looping statement. Let's say for. So here I'm iterating. So I'm taking int I 0. I'm starting from 0. And I less than, how many times we have to repeat, it depends upon the number of child nodes. So I less than node list. How we will know that how many nodes are there in the node list? We have a method called get length. So this will give you how many child nodes are there. Like this is, we are here, we captured all the child nodes, but how many are there? That we can count by using get length. And then every time I'll iterate by one, so I can say I plus plus. Okay. Now, from this node list, we have to extract each and every node from XML file. For example, this is one node, this is another node, this is another node. One by one, we have to extract. So to extract this particular child node from the root node, we have to use this node list. We already captured all the child nodes. So from the node list, we have one method called item. Here we have to pass index called I. And this will return particular node that we are going to store in a variable called node. And the type of this variable is also node. So now this node also we have to import from w3c.dom. org.w3c.dom. Okay, now we capture the one node, first node. Because I value 0, we get the first node. And from this particular node, we have to extract each and every tag. And again, this tag, every tag is representing as an element. So we need to extract every node or every tag, and then we have extracted the data. So before extracting, so we already captured this node. So in this node, we have to get, we have to get each and every tag. So for that, what we can do is we have to first check one condition, like this particular node, okay, if this particular node and dot get node type. So we have to get the node type actually. Okay, if that node type is element, then we're able to extract the data. So here we put one condition equal to node dot element node. If it is an element type of node, then we are able to extract the data. So what we are doing is, if this particular node is having elements, if it is element node, then we are able to capture this data. So this is the condition. If node dot get node type equal to element node, then what we need to do, we have to capture element, that particular element. So how to capture element? We need to capture the node. So we already captured the node, right? First node. From the first node, again, we have to capture the tag, every tag, and then we have to extract the text content. So from this particular node, we have to capture the element. So we need to capture the element. And basically, we have to convert this node into element type. So we need to typecast as an element. Okay, so here what we have done is this particular node, right? So we have captured all the node list here. And then we have captured the first node. From the node list, we have captured the first node. And inside the first node, if it is a node type equal to element node, then we are converting that node into element type. So this is the element type. And now from this element, we have to capture the tag name. So element dot get a tag name. So this will give the tag name. So that we are going to store in another variable. I'll name it as a tag name. And again, the type of this variable is a string, because tag names are string. Now by using this tag name, okay, and by using this tag name, we have to extract the data. And this is a tag name, right? So from the element, we have extracted the tag name. And from the element, we can also extract the text content, element dot get text content. So once we get an element, we can extract the tag name, and also we can extract the text content. If you look at the XML file, so these are all elements actually. So this is one node. From this node, these are all elements. From every element, we have to extract the tag name. That is optional. If you want to just get only data, tag name is optional. And I'm just capturing the tag name along with the content also. And if you get this element, you will be able to get. So here from this element, I'm getting the tag name. Now also getting the text content. So that is also string. String text content. Okay. So once you get an element, from that element, I'm getting the tag name and text content. And after that, I'm directly printing here. I can say println. I'm also printing the tag name. If you don't want tag name, you can simply directly print the text content. So I'm printing the tag name. And this is the tag name. And then I'm also printing the content. So here, text content. In that particular tag, what is the text content which we have? I can say text content. So this is a variable. In this, we have captured the text content. That's it. So this loop will repeat multiple times. So what this loop will do is, first of all, let me open both. So here in this particular example, in the for loop, what we are doing, first we are getting the node list. So node list is nothing but what? This is one node, this is another node, this is another node. There are multiple nodes are there. So we are counting the length, how many nodes are there. From every, from the node list, we are getting the item. Item means what? This is one item, this is another item, this is another item. So once we extracted one item into the node, so this is comes under one node. And then, so from this particular node, we are getting the tag name along with the content. So we are converting the node into element, and element.tagName, element.text, and text content, and we are got printing this. So this will repeat for every child node in XML file. Okay. So let us try to execute it. So this is enough. So this will read XML file data. So let us try to execute it here. This is a file we have specified directly inside the builder.parse. Okay. So when I execute this, it should read all the data from the XML. Yeah. Now you can just look at here. This is my XML file. And if I look at this, so first tag name is employee. This is a node. And inside this, this is the content which we have. So you can see 101, John Kennedy Engineer 8000. This is one node. And another tag name. So this is a one. From this, again, we have captured this data. And this is another child node. And this is another child node. Okay. So like this, we can just read the data from XML file using Java DOM parser. So this is a very popular inbuilt Java library, which is available. And using this, we can simply parse any type of XML document. You can have any number of child nodes, any type of nodes. We will able to read the content from the XML file. So once you read the data from the content or from XML file, we can also use the data for our testing and any other purposes. Okay. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.